Good morning. Today we'll be doing the Liturgy of the Hours morning prayer for June 9th. Today is the Sunday of the 10th week in Ordinary Time. Let's have that moment of silence to prepare us for a prayer. God, come to my assistance.
Lord, make haste to help me.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Alleluia.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Alleluia.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his love endures forever.
Let the sons of Israel say, his love endures forever. Let the sons of Aaron say, his love endures forever. Let those who fear the Lord say, his love endures forever.
I called to the Lord in my distress. He answered and freed me. The Lord is at my side. I do not fear. What can man do against me? The Lord is at my side as my helper. I shall look down on my foes.
It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in men. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in princes.
The nations all encompass me. In the Lord's name I cross them. They compass me about. In the Lord's name I cross them. They compass me about like bees. They bless like a fire among thorns. In the Lord's name I crushed them.
I was hard pressed and was falling, but the Lord came to help me. The Lord is my strength and my song. He is my Savior. There are shouts of joy and victory in the tents of the just.
The Lord's right hand has triumphed. His right hand raised me up. The Lord's right hand has triumphed. I shall not die. I shall live and recount his deeds. I was punished by the Lord, but not doomed to die.
Open to me the gates of holiness. I will enter and give thanks. This is the Lord's own gate, where the just may enter. I will thank you, for you have answered, and you are my Savior.
The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. This is the work of the Lord, a marvel in our eyes. This day was made by the Lord. We rejoice and are glad.
O Lord, grant us salvation. O Lord, grant success. Blessed is the name of the Lord, is he who comes. We bless you from the house of the Lord. The Lord God is our light.
Go forward in procession with branches, even to the altar. You are my God. I thank you. My God, I praise you. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his love endures forever.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Alleluia.
Let us sing a hymn of praise to our God. Alleluia.
Blessed are you, O Lord, the God of our fathers, praiseworthy and exalted above all forever.
And blessed is your holy and glorious name, praiseworthy and exalted above all ages.
Blessed are you in the temple of your holy glory, praiseworthy and glorious above all forever.
Blessed are you on the throne of your kingdom, praiseworthy and exalted above all forever.
Blessed are you who look into the depths from your throne upon the cherubim, praiseworthy and exalted above all forever.
Blessed are you in the firmament of heaven, praiseworthy and glorious forever.
Bless the Lord, all you works of the Lord. Praise and exalt him above all forever.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
Let us sing a hymn of praise to our God. Alleluia.
Praise the Lord for his infinite greatness. Alleluia.
Praise God in his holy place. Praise him in his mighty heavens. Praise him for his powerful deeds. Praise his surpassing greatness.
Oh, praise him with sound of trumpet. Praise him with lute and harp. Praise him with timbrel and dance. Praise him with string and pipes.
Oh, praise him with resounding cymbals. Praise him with clashing of cymbals. Let everything that lives and that are blessed give praise to the Lord.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Praise the Lord for his infinite greatness. Alleluia.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. I will spring clean water upon you to cleanse you from all your impurities, and from your idols I will cleanse you. I will give you a new heart and place a new spirit within you, taking from your bodies your stony hearts and giving you natural hearts. I will put my spirit within you and make you live by my statutes, careful to observe my decrees. You shall live in the land I gave your fathers. You shall be my people, and I will be your God. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Our natural hearts are patterned from the one who created us. Our Creator's heart is all about love, and His statutes are all about love. When our Creator, God, speaks of a new heart, He actually meant returning our original heart to love others. Our new spirit is the one that longs to be with our Creator, our God. Our worldly life, with all our struggles, draws us away from God. The need to provide and be secured is replaced by the need to have more and more, acquiring the so-called security just to provide material needs is very addicting. Provisions, which is originally driven by love, is replaced by guilt. God's statutes is all about love and sharing the goods of the earth, and it's quite the opposite of greed. In baptism, we are restored to our new heart. Originally designed by God, our Creator, remembering our baptism, also known as cleansing waters, returns our natural hearts. Hearts that love is the heart that shares to others God's provisions.
We give thanks to you, O God, as we call upon your name.
We give thanks to you, O God, as we call upon your name.
We cry aloud, how marvelous you are,
as we call upon your name.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
We give thanks to you, O God, as we call upon your name.
Whoever does the will of God, he is my brother and my sister and my mother.
Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to his people and set them free.
He has raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of his servant David.
Through his holy prophets, he promised of old that he would save us from our enemies, from the hands of all who hate us.
He promised to show mercy to our fathers and to remember his holy covenant.
This was his oath he swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight all the days of our life.
You, my child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins.
In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadows of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
My heart and my flesh rejoice in the living God. Let us give thanks to our Savior who came into this world as God's presence among us. Let us call upon Him.
Christ, King of glory, be our light and our joy. Lord Jesus, you are the rising sun, the first fruits of the future resurrection. Grant that we may not sit in the shadow of death, but and walk in the light of life. Show us your goodness, present in every creature,
that we may contemplate your glory everywhere.
Do not allow us to be overcome by evil today.
but grant that we may overcome evil through the power of good.
You were baptized in the Jordan and anointed by the Holy Spirit.
Grant that we may this day give thanks to your Holy Spirit.
Let us pause for a moment to lift up our prayers and petitions to our Lord Jesus Christ. Dear Lord Jesus, we lift up to you our prayers and our petitions, together with the prayers and petitions of each and everyone who are praying with us this morning. We ask, dear Jesus, that you hear and answer each and every prayer as we pray.
Christ, King of glory, be our light and our joy. Lord, remember us when you come into your kingdom and teach us how to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Let us pray. God of wisdom and love, source of all good, send your Spirit to teach us your truth and guide our actions in your way of peace. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Almighty God bless you, Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace and glorify the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you for praying with us.
We hope you join us again tomorrow.
Same time,
same place,
same channel. Have a great day.